The Philippine government likely to pursue a planned importation of sugar. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. earlier said the country might import 150,000 metric tons of sugar due to supply issues. Press Secretary Trixie Cruz Angeles says this is aimed at helping industries cope with high sugar prices.
Yun po ang proposed na quantity for importation, gawa nga ng pangangailangan ng mga industrials na tinatawag ng ating Pangulo. Sila po ang gumagamit in commercial quantities, in large commercial quantities ng asukal, and some jobs are dependent on their continued production.
Malacanang also warns traders against hoarding sugar. Executive Secretary Vic Rodriguez says Thursday's raid on a Pampanga warehouse is proof government will go after those hoarding stocks of sugar in order to profit from what he called an artificial shortage situation. Customs agents seized thousands of sacks of imported sugar from Thailand from the warehouse in Pampanga. Press Secretary Cruz Angeles says more raids may be implemented in the coming days. Rising sugar prices in the Philippines starting to take a toll on medicine manufacturers. A group says their production is already affected as up to 30% of syrup and suspensions formulation is composed of sugar. The Philippine Pharmaceutical Manufacturers Association hopes the government would focus on strengthening local sugar production.
Ang ginagamit namin ay special sugar, yung refined sugar. April 2022, umabot na to sa 62.
Small business owners not immune from the impact of sugar supply woes. The Philippine Association of Stores and Karinderia Owners fears a prolonged supply issue could lead to lower earnings for their members. This, as the group points out, some stores are already seeing a decreased supply of products like soft drinks and other beverages from wholesalers. It hopes for immediate actions to resolve high sugar costs. The United Sugar Producers Federation questions claims of a shortage in refined sugar. Its president, Manuel Lamata, insists there's still some supply left from an earlier batch of imports. He believes supply is not the issue, but overpricing.
Imagine they buy sugar from us at 45 pesos per kilo and they're selling it at 100, 110. The importation of 200,000 metric tons of refined, which came in June of this year, and it's still coming in. I think there's another batch of 20,000 tons left to be coming in the country. 130,000 plus is still in the bodegas, not withdrawn. DTI should step up to the plate and inspect all sugar mills, all bodegas of the traders.
Former Agriculture Secretary Leonardo Montemayor meanwhile believes the Sugar Regulatory Administration consulted with stakeholders before declaring the need to import more supply. But he is not dismissing profiteering behind the rising prices of sugar.
When you look at it on its face value, rising prices would be an indicator, but not the only indicator of a gap between the demand, in this case for sugar, and the supply, whether actual or projected. I think there is also a strong case for the point, I believe, made by Manolet Lamata here, that there is likely profiteering. Ang laki po ng agwat ng buying price for their cane and their raw sugar as against the retail price.